Good morning, students. So today we are going to start a new chapter, that is Glimpses of India. This chapter is having three parts. First one is a baker from Goa, second part Kurg, and the last one tea from Assam. Now here that we are going to discuss about the first part, a baker from Goa. Now in this chapter, especially this part, the writer Lucio Rodrigues, that almost it means this literary genius that belongs to Goa, that place, so that empire, he has written the accounts of that traditional, especially the Goan village bakers or the parlor, right? So it is a pale portrait of a traditional Goan village which is given by this writer Lucio Rodrigues. This man, he has especially translated from it means his English work or the so many essays into the Kokni language, or the his child almost died in 1973 nearby. So this is in short about the writer. Now if we look at this writer, especially this first part, baker from Goa, it is a plain portrait of a traditional Goan village baker. Plain portrait is given, and generally we know that when we discuss, when we recall our childhood, definitely we will recall some such traditional people or such like bakers or so many other people. And across the country we have so many such places where we could visit and we could recall the places, maybe the historical places, geographical, religious, cultural, such places we have plenty of such places which known in the world, also which comes in the wonders of the world among them. So the writer has given such an account, and in the introduction itself the writer has asked, do you remember any such place which ever that you have visited? So definitely you might have visited different places, for example Taj Mahal, for example Charminar, or the so many places, or especially in the southern part of India, right, or the hill stations. So now here one plain portrait is given of a traditional Goan village, village baker. Especially the writer talks here about a village baker or a father, and especially the importance of this man, this village baker or a father, importance of this man in society or in Goan villages, that importance is given. And actually when the lesson starts, when this first part starts, that time the writer said, because writer he himself belongs to Goa, that area or the region, so very beautifully that he has picturized especially this traditional man or the baker in the Goan village. So in the very beginning the writer says that the elders of the village, right, are often heard, it means we often heard that the elders of the village reminiscing nostalgically about this man, it means village breakers of the father, or that it means that they used to reminisce, it means recall nostalgically about the Portuguese days. Especially in Goa we know that Portuguese, they ruled, it means there they came, that they had arrived there. So that is why the elders that very fondly, nostalgically means fondly, lovingly, that they recalled those days, especially the Portuguese days. And the Portuguese and their famous, that is the loaves, L-O-A-V-E-S, loaves. Portuguese days and their famous loaves of bread, who reminisced, who recalled. The writer said, we often heard our elders that they reminisced about, nostalgically about the Portuguese days and their famous loaves of bread. Right? And after that, the writer says that those eaters of the loaves, they might have vanished. Eaters of the loaves might have vanished, but still the makers are still there. Right? Makers. We could see their existence, for example, today also we could see the mixtures, molders, all these things the writer has given. Mixtures, molders, and those who bake the loaves. Right? Such people today, eaters that they might have vanished, but still the makers, for example, and the mixtures, molders, all these things are available today. Also, it means still exist. Right? And especially then the age-old time-tested furnaces, these things are also available. Right? Age-old time-tested furnaces have not been extinguished. Still that they are available, that they are existed, which are used to make, for example, the breads, for the loaves of bread, for the bakers. The devices are available. Eaters might have extinguished, but still the devices by which mixers, molders, or for example, these age-old time-tested furnaces, or the loaves of the bread, all these things are available still in the Bowen village. Then later on, the writer talks about that the thud or the jingling sound of the traditional baker's bamboo. It means whenever, for example, these such bakers that they used to come in the village, that they used to arrive in the village, especially in the morning, their arrival means with the sound. It means jingling, it means thud sound or the jingling sound of the traditional baker's bamboo or the stick. Right? That was their arrival on the stage. And it means it used the heralding. Heralding means announcement of their arrival. As soon as the people used to listen or they heard the thud or the jingling sound of the bamboos, it means the baker has arrived. It means that was the siren, that was the heralding of his arrival. So that is why this man is having a lot of importance, especially in Bowen village. Writer says that maybe the father is not alive now, but still dear children or the son, that he carries the profession. It means the profession has not been left by the child or the son, though the father is not alive there, but son still carries the profession to the next generation. And these are known as father, P-A-D-P-R, or sometimes it is pronounced as Pader or Pader in a Bowen village, P-A-D-P-R, Pader or Pader, right? It is known, so that is why it is having immense importance in the Bowen village. So we have seen how the old people that they used to reminisce, recall about the old Portuguese days and their loaves of bread. Next, eaters might have extinguished, but still the makers are there. For example, the mixers, in the form of mixers, molders, or the in the form of furnaces, all these things. It means fire, which has not been yet extinguished. Then the arrival of this man in the Bowen village with the jingling sound of the bamboo, old traditional bamboo. And though the father may not alive, but still the son carries his profession to the next generation. And so that is why even today these people are known as Pader in Bowen village. Right? So the writer talks about later on the childhood. Writer's childhood. Because I told you, the writer belongs to that region, Bowen village. So then the writer, he recalled his childhood. Nostalgically, fondly that he recalled, he said that in our childhood, this man, this baker, especially this baker during our childhood, he used to be our friend, companion and guide. Right? See now, the way children, they had a culture about this man in their childhood, including the narrator, that just like a friend, companion and guide. So this was, and he used to come in the village twice in a day. Question is given, it means at how many times, at what times that he used to come in the village? Twice a day. First, that for example, when he set out in the morning, starting first time, when he set out in the morning selling his, for example, his bags or the bread. First round, whenever that he used to arrive in the village, that was his first round, set out in the morning. And the next one, after finishing his finishing the things or the content from that huge basket, emptying the huge basket and returning to his home, that was the second. So twice that he used to come in a day, first of all when he set out in the morning, and later on when after emptying his huge basket, it means returning to his home. So that is what, twice a day that he used to arrive in the village, the narrator's village. This is what twice is given here. It means twice a day that he used to come. And he used to come, it means with the jingling of the sound of his traditional bamboos. And because of that sound, all the children from that village, his sound woke us up from the sleep, and we ran to meet and greet him. Who ran? The children. Listening the jingling sound of that traditional bamboo, woke up from the sleep, ran to meet and greet him, the children. Now, and in this way, ran to meet and greet him. So, loaves were brought. But it was not, the narrator said, we ran towards him not for the love of that sound or something else, or not for the loaves, right? The children ran to him to greet or to meet him, not for the sake of loves. The narrator has asked two questions, was it so, for the sake of love or longing for this loaves? No, for not this one, but the narrator he himself said that the loaves or the bread, that definitely that they were collected by the servants, right? Names are given, Pascain or something here, right? Pascain or the Bastion, but actually that they were not longed for all these things, loaves, the children. They were not coming, they were not running towards this man, the baker in the village. But instead of that, they longed for bread bangles. Right, the children, that they were longed for bread bangles, which he specially that he used to bring for the children. Maybe for the bread bangles, or sometimes for the sweet bread, which he had specially that he used to make for the children. So that is why children woke up from the sleep and ran to meet and greet him. Right, not for the sake of loaves, but for the sake of bread bangles, which that they chose carefully, and plus another thing, that is a sweet bread which he had made special for the children. So for that sake, the children that they used to run to meet and greet him. After that, he made the his musical entry, especially his entry on the scene with the music, just like on the scene, his musical entry with the help of the jingling sound or the jank sound of the bamboos, traditional bamboos. That was his entry in the village. A kind of way. It means, for example, bamboo is there in this way. For example, with the sound of the bamboo that he used to come. That was his the signal of his arrival. Bamboo staff. So, in the way that he used to come there, for example, one hand supported with the basket on the head. Basket on the, he used to carry basket on the head, and one hand would be supported to that basket, and another hand, what he would do? That he used to carry that bamboo. Now in this way, right? One hand to the basket on the head, and another hand to the bamboo, the traditional bamboo, in this way that he used to stamping on the ground, that he used to come there with the sound, this man in the village. And one more after the action, supporting basket, and he used to greet the ladies in the village. Question is there, listen carefully, how he used to greet the ladies of the in that village, right? He used to greet the ladies with good mornings, because early morning that he used to come, because of the sound of his that bamboo, that jingling sound, the children plus the people, that they woke up from the sleep, and they definitely that they came to know, that they understood that the man has come, baker has come. Sometimes it is known as a padar or the peda in the Gogal village. That man has come with the loaves of bread, right? And he greeted the ladies of the village with saying good morning. Later on, that he used to place his basket, he used to place his basket on the vertical bamboo. It means his basket on that vertical bamboo that he used to place, and later on, after that, the kids, when the kids that they used to surround him, that they used to come near of him, just like in the form of crowds, that he used to rebuke them, a kind of he used to push them aside with a mild rebuke. Mild rebuke means not that much in an extreme way, or not that much extent, just like a soft scolding, we could say, right? That man, whenever the children that they used to rush there, the man, that baker, that he used to almost put them aside with a mild rebuke. But the children also, they did not give up. Though that they had been rebuked by the baker, but they did not give up. What the children that they used to do? That they used to climb on the on a bench, and plus climb on a wall, that small wall something is given, and picked into the basket, right? They did not give up. Though that they had been scolded by him, they used to climb on a bench, on a small wall, and they used to peep into the basket. So in this way, that is what the curiosity of the children is given here, right? So after that, the man, the baker, that he used to, it means loaves would be delivered to the servant, because children were coming, already we have explained, not for the sake of loaves of the bread, they were coming for the sake of bread bangles or sweet bread, right? Which specially that he used to bring for the children. So then the loaves would be delivered to the servants by the baker, right? But the children, that they in between their effort is to climb on a wall or a bench and to see, to peep into his basket. But still, narrator still recalls the typical fragrance of the loaves. See now, the narrator is, it means he is grown up now. He is elder now, but still the narrator recalls his childhood memories. Nostalgically, fondly that he recalled, especially the typical fragrance of the loaves, that the scent of the loaves that he recalls, he recalled, and we did not, and the narrator said, at that time, we did not, it means care to brush our teeth or to wash the mouth before eating that bread bangles or that sweet cake. We did not care. And the narrator had used one statement there, that who would take the trouble, who would go there to take the trouble to pluck the mango leaf and to brush our teeth and then wash our mouth, who would take the trouble? And the narrator has used one statement, this statement, the tiger never brushed his teeth. It means that for themselves, for the children, the narrator, he himself used this statement, the tiger never brushed his
tick.
Because children that day did not care to brush the tick, wash mouth before eating anything in the morning. Instead of that, they said this statement. Now, and according to them, they knew that what would happen with the hot tea, it could wash and clean everything. When we would drink hot tea, no need to brush our teeth or wash the mouth, it would clean and wash up everything. Right? So in this way, the part number one, baker from Goa, it means almost half of this part is over. Few things are left that will continue in the another video module. Thank you and have a good day.